My name is Ios Dux, I'm a professional Overwatch coach, and I have a few tips up my sleeve that might help you aim. Don't miss out on any future videos by headshotting that subscribe button and join the Discord to ask questions. Mouse sensor position is something that a lot of players don't think about at all, but it is more important than you may think. Depending on how you grip your mouse and which mouse you use in the first place, your mouse sensor can be further away or closer to the pivot points. For wrist aimers, that's the wrist, and for arm aimers, that's the wrist and elbow. So why is this important? Well, it's a bit mathematical, but let me explain. Have you ever seen one of those old vinyl record players? Don't you find it interesting how the record always moves at the same speed, which means that the revolutions per minute is constant? So the needle completes one full revolution in the same amount of time, no matter how far away from the center of the record you're looking. So the record turns at the same speed, yet the needle crosses a much larger distance while being at the edge of the record than when near the center. Now here's what I want you to imagine next. Let's change the record player's needle with a mouse sensor. If we put the sensor at the edge of the record, it is going to detect much more of movement than if we would put it near the center of the record, even though the record is spinning at a constant rate. And now let's translate that into actual arm and wrist movement. Let's say you turn your wrist by exactly 30 degrees. You would think that the amount you turn in-game would be consistent, but it's not. If your mouse sensor is closer to the rotation's origin, it is going to translate to a much smaller turn in-game, whereas if your mouse sensor is further away from the rotation's origin, in this case your wrist or your elbow, that means that the same turn or flick of the wrist is going to cross a much larger gap. And that is problematic, because players tend to change their grip slightly mid-game, or they swap mice and just translate the sensitivity one-to-one. If a mouse has its center near the back and another one near the front, then that is going to cause slight changes in how your wrist movements translate in-game. I know that all of this sounds really complicated, but it's important that you keep this in mind. If you ever feel like your aim is just slightly off on a certain day, make sure that the distance between your mouse sensor and your wrist or elbow, depending on how you aim, remains consistent. That's it for today's video. Make sure to subscribe so you can see the other parts of Aim Secrets and join the Discord community to become a part of something bigger. My name is Ios Dux, and I'd like to thank you for learning.